You're listening to KEXP. You can find us at 90.3 FM in Seattle, streaming around the world at kexp.org. I'm Cheryl Waters. I am beyond delighted to have Kate Tempest and her band live in studio today. Welcome so much here to our studio here in Seattle.
Thanks for having us in.
It is wonderful to have you here, fresh off a sold-out show at the Neptune Theater and maybe a few hours sleep. We can't thank you all so much for getting up this early. And Let Them Eat Chaos, one of my favorite records from last year, and seeing you perform it live is just otherworldly. I'm so excited you're here to do that today.
Cool. So we thought what we'd do is, because last time we were on KXP from Iceland Airways, we played the first kind of 20 minutes of the record, so we're going to pick the album up just after the halfway point, and you'll hear the stories of three characters and then the final track. So we're kind of coming in halfway through a story, but I think that it's okay. Hopefully you'll go with us. So this is the second half of Let Them Eat Chaos. On the second floor of the new build block with the yellow door, next to the boarded up independent record store, Bradley is awake. He's watching notches on his clock face, lying there thinking his limbs are like fallen buildings, and he's feeling like every single day he's lived is out to kill him. Now Bradley's got a good job. He works in PR. He moved south a few months back. Top whack flat, all mod cons, got them wall-sized windows. He's a Manchester boy, done good in the big smoke. Young professional, single, Tinder and flings. Life seems simpler than it's ever been. He's doing well. He's living the dream. And he's paying his mortgage off. Bradley doesn't know why he's not sleeping at night. He could get up, try and walk it off, but he's got to get to work in a matter of hours. Is he awake or asleep? He can't tell, he can't dream, he can't feel, he can't scream. He just stares at his screen. It says 4:18, and life's just a thing that he does. Bradley rolls over, cold pillow, warm body. At the end of his tether, as usual, he breathes softly. He burrows down deep, and he closes his eyes, and he thinks, man, is this really what it means to be alive? Go past like pictures on a screen. Sometimes I feel like my life is someone else's dream. Most days I'm dazed, walking around, I'm working, talking, perking up, but always feel I can't be certain that I've woken up at all. Is this life? Will this pass? This feeling like I'm looking at the world from behind glass. Even when I'm laughing hard or falling on my or half plastered before it's even dark, or when some hard bastard barges past, when I'm passing my targets at work, I can't shake the feeling that life hasn't started. It's worse in the evenings at parties. I'm standing apart, my heart's hard, I can't hardly be heard. Still I'm harping on, barking out words. Is this me? Is this what I'm doing? I know I exist, but I don't feel a thing. I'm eclipsed, I'm elsewhere, and the worst part is I don't think that I care. What am I gonna do to wake up? I know it's happening, but who's it happening to? Has this happened to you? I know it's happening, but who is it happening to? Has it happened to you? I know it's happening, but who's it happening to? Has this happened to you? I know it's happening, but who is it happening to? Has it happened to you? I try new things, I shoot films on my phone, and I play them back when I'm alone. Did that happen? I walk around trying to understand every sound, trying to make my feet connect with every inch of ground. The sky flattens, my cap battens me down. Everything's in its category, package and sell, flattering girls. Battle reality is battle royale. Everyone's chattering, nothing is real. Collect my salary, cooking a meal, rice and vegetables. I exercise regularly, but how do I feel? Whistle a melody, is this all that's ahead of me. I always thought that life would mean more to me. Eventually, I hate to think I'll make it to 70, potentially 75. Realize I've never been alive. Spend the rest of my days regretting, wishing I could be forgetting. Oh, it's happening, but who's it happening to? Has this happened to you? I know it's happening, but who is it happening to? Has it happened to you? I know it's happening, but who's it happening to? Has this happened to you? I know it's happening, but who is it happening to?
What am I gonna do to wake up?
Just a few doors down from Bradley, in the old ramshackle house with the broken down porch and the novelty doorbell, Zoe plays her music low. She's got a bottle on the go. Everything's in boxes. It's been a long night packing. She's got her clothes in black bin bags and the blue tack greases the paintwork. Zoe's like, man, what the is all this stuff? She's got the road signs stolen from Quick Shag Street. Shirts and skirts, posters, CDs, comedy coasters, broken TV. Birthday card that her sister made in a distant past when she turned 13. Hair stuff, books, love letters she can't bin. Outside the night, inside it's the last hurrah. There's her limited edition Air Max 110s. Next to her Che Guevara bust, complete with his ornamental glass cigar. Now for years, the landlord never fixed the shower, and the mold kept growing up the kitchen walls. He'd do it up nice now, sure, repaint it. He's tripled the rent, he's gonna get it and all. Zoe's only got a few hours left to get her room all packed and clean. She goes to her window, she lights up a smoke. She looks down at the street. It's 4:18. The squats we used to party in our flats we can't afford. The dump. When was this a white? called for. All for the rich, if you fall short, you fall, and you know where the door is. Board up the broken, do it up, sell it back. Make it bespoke, it's all out in the open. It's fine, man, hike the price right up, and then smile with your friends in the posh new nightclubs. My streets have been dug up, repaved. New routes for commuters, landscapes have changed. Looking for the old graph, the tags that once said safe territory, but every hieroglyph gets whitewashed eventually. She twitches, wired. She lies beside a sleeping woman, a girl she barely knows. She met her in the pub, and yes, it went the way it goes. The girl's name is Rose, but Pius is lovesick for her thorn. Her thorn left her a couple of summers back. Since then, Pius can't get warm. She has carried her stuck in her side since the day that she was born. She dreamed of her and knew her shape long before she saw her form. But now it's 4:18, and Pius has been staring at the walls for hours. She tells herself this is all her fault. She doesn't love, she just devours. Can't sleep, so much to do. Trying to get closer to you when you're so far away. Trying to get hold of what's true, and what's true isn't true when it's day. Tell me, how can I sleep? Got so much to do. I'm trying to get closer to you and you're so far away. All that I say and I do are things that you do and you say. How come I'm becoming the one that I'm running from? Hunted by, slurring my words in the pub, feeling nervous, overexcited. Arms down the waist of a girl who might make it alright for a nightmare. She takes me to pieces, and I lie beside her awake while she sleeps, and I feel much closer to you than I felt when you were still here. Spill beer till you reappear. I'm thinking of you and the things you do to me. I'm thinking of you.
thinking of
you and the things you do to me. I'm thinking of you and the things you do to me.
This in my mind, get out of it, you didn't want it. How come you're still hanging around in it? This in my body, let go of it, you didn't want it. How come you're still controlling it? This in my night, get lost in it. This in my bridge, stop crossing it. This in my space, stop smiling. And this is my face, you've been gone so long. How come I still find you hiding? Fighting me, I'm fighting my darkest past. And I'm frightened, nightmares tighten. My hands around my own throat, cause you're the snake charmer and I'm the old rope. No hope, just go now, please, just leave. Still in the air, the tide breathe, I'm stranded. Arms outstretched for my body, anybody. Here's a body, but I wake up, I can't stand them. I feel so grubby, no one can't stop, just love me. Breath like a cigarette, stopped in the guts of. Please come close, no wait, don't touch me, it's ugly. Push and pull, phone call, beep, beep, look at me. Names for the one that feels the most dangerous. I can't believe you're in love again. I can't open my heart to anybody but strangers. I'm thinking of
you and the things you do to me. I'm thinking of you and the things you do to me.
So here is our moment, frozen. We have seen our seven unmoving in their lonely homes. It's been 4:18 and dawn is still hours off yet. My gosh, and they are cold and listless. They are not quite sure that they even exist here in this moment, slow and viscous, lips haunted by the ghosts of kisses. There is the endless saturation of the days. And here they are. And there is nothing moving but their breath. But watch now as the breaking storm outside brings this moment into action. The sky cracks into a wild-mouthed grin and unleashes all the water that it's carried. Vapor grown heavy from every distant puddle, every lapping wave tip, every single churning river is contributing to this rain, this rain, this rain. The lightning charges up their hearts, it rips the sky in half and it startles every rooftop into stark relief. And hour seven, they see their city new. So Pete on his doorstep looks up, mouth agape, drops his keys in shock and laughs, a howling ancient laugh. Esther unleashes a strange bark into the silence of her kitchen. Gemma sits bolt upright in bed and stares at the rain as it smashes itself against her window. Zoe puts her boxes down. Bradley reaches for his dressing gown. Now see it from above. Seven doors to seven flats open at the same time and light the raining pavement. Seven broken hearts, seven empty faces heading out of doors. Here's our seven perfect strangers, and they see each other. Strangely dressed, one shoe and one slipper, socks falling off, slowly at first, tentatively, but then unhunching their shoulders, tipping their necks back, opening their bodies to this rain, and their hair is slicked down against their heads or it's puffed up madly outwards, and their hands are slipping from their cheeks and chins as they clutch their faces open-mouthed. Amazing, they shout. Have you seen it? They shout as they flock like children into the eye of a game, shocked and laughing, standing in it, standing in it, standing in it, standing in it, soaked to the skin.
of our discontent upon us. Desolate apostles slurping stronger at the crossroads. Are we nothing but an eating mouth, a sophocles colossal? Won't stop until we're beating down the planet into pellets before the interstellar mission to inflict more terror. It's killing me, it's killing me, it's filling me. I'm vomiting, it's stilling me. Everything is fine, really silly me. Poor kid shot dead, poor kid locked up. Poor kid saying this is the future that you left us. Stocked up lunch meat, processed punch from an unclean fat cat. Tasting tasty poison, carcinogenic, diabetic, asthmatic, epileptic, post-traumatic, bipolar and disaffected. Atomized, thinking we're engaged when we're pacified. Staring at the screen so we don't have to see the planet die. What we gonna do to wake up? We sleep so deep, it don't matter how they shake us. If we can't face it, we can't escape it. But tonight the storms come. She's screaming, the drones turned a beautiful boy into a pile of bones. Nobody to bury, nobody is home. She's running from war, the boat's full, the boat's sinking a mile offshore. No beds in the hospitals, our minds are against us. Imagine your daughter was gunned down defenseless. On her way to school, there'd be uproar. But she's collateral damage, it never happened. Now if our kids are fine, that's enough for us. Gone off into a vacuum, got to be a limit. Welcome to the biggest crime that's ever been committed. You think you and I are different kinds, caught up in specifics. You and I apart are much easier to limit. The illusions are complete, impossible to bring it into focus. Cinematic stop, put his teachers be by the locus. Our uniform and keep unleashing explosive. Now what we gonna do to wake up? We sleep so deep, no matter how they shake us. If we can't face it, we can't escape it. If we can't face it, we can't escape it. Tunnel vision, tunnel vision. Work drinks, heartbreak. Can't face the past a dark place. Can't sleep, can't wake. Sitting in our boxes, notching up our victories as other people's losses. Another day, another chance to turn your face away from pain. Let's get a takeaway. I'll meet you in the pub a little later. Say the same things as ever. Life's a waiting game. When are we going to see that life is happening right now? That every single body bleeding on its knees is an abomination. That every natural being is making communication. That we are just sparks, tiny little parts of a much bigger constellation. Minuscule molecules that make up one body. The tragedy and pain of a person you have never even met is present in your nightmares and in your pull towards despair. The sickness in this culture, the sickness in our hearts, is a sickness that's inflicted by the distance that we share. They were our bombs that started this war, and now it rages at distance. We can dismiss all its victims as strangers. These are parents and children made dogs by this danger. But existence is futile, so we don't engage. They were my boats that sailed, killed, stole, and made frail. They were our boots that stamped, they were our courts that jailed, they were our banks that got bailed. And it was us who turned bleakly away. Look back down at our nails and our wedding plans. In the face of a full force gale, we said it's not up to us to make this place a better land. Justice. Justice, recompense, humility, trust is something we will never see until love is unconditional. The myth of the individual has left us disconnected, lost and pitiful. I'm out in the rain, it's a cold night in London, and I'm pleading with my loved ones to wake up and love more. On a screen in front of a whole bunch of strangers saying, do what you remember, please wake up and love more.
We'll be right back.
absolutely incredible. We're live in the KEXP studios with Kate Tempest from her album Let Them Eat Chaos. The band having a moment there. I need a moment. Wow, thank you so much for that. That was incredible.
Well, thanks for giving us the opportunity to play to your listeners.
It is always a pleasure to see you perform live. I saw you first at Sasquatch when Everybody Down came out, and I was blown away and couldn't wait to hear more from you. And then Let Them Eat Chaos came out late last year. Absolutely a masterpiece. And Kate, you have packed so much into those 13 songs. I mean, it's very topical. You talk about poverty, consumerism, the state of the world, and you really tap into people's frustration and anger, but there's also a lot of beauty and optimism and hope, and as you end in tunnel vision there, love and joy. And we could talk about those stories all day long, but I feel like people can listen to the record. It's just all there laid bare. And what fascinates me is your intense interest in people through your records and your books and your poetry. You write about human lives. And I'm curious about that. You grew up in a city packed with people, and you seem to see the individual. And that's the perspective that you come from in all the work that you do. And I'm curious about that.
Well, I'm not quite sure why that would be a curious thing for a writer to be interested in people. James Joyce says, in the particular is located the universal. You know, and this is something that I believe in very truly, that the more you look, the closer you examine, the wider your perspective and the more that you can understand. You know, the more that you really allow yourself to pay attention to detail. And because we're so assaulted, our senses are so assaulted, in cities especially, we can forget to just blink a couple of times and look again. And the kind of monstrosity of huge cities that can feel like machines, you know, we begin to lose our humanity in such a synthetic environment. But that's not really true. That's just a feeling that the city gives because we're tired. If you look again, the city is full of human life and natural life too. There's, you know, there is still nature flourishing somehow. And I think that for a writer, for a poet, you can't help but be tuned in to life on a particular frequency where you're very sensitive, you're very open. And if I wasn't writing and making the kind of portraits or examinations that I am, then I probably have, do you know what I mean, lost the plot by now. So it's so loud in my brain, you know, if it doesn't come out, then yeah, I don't know what would happen.
I'm curious to know what kind of influences that you had and how you encourage others. I feel like through, you're also a teacher to many, and what you, do you feel a responsibility, or maybe this isn't a great question either, to sort of help people along the way in a way that you were helped? I guess what I'm asking is, do you feel like people helped you along the way? And
yeah, of course. Here's someone who's helped me very much. This is Craig Bass, who is my childhood friend and longtime collaborator. Here's someone who helps me very much. This is Archie Marsh. She's playing the synths. And we've been playing together since we were teenagers. This is Hanako Amari, who's playing the synths. She helps me very much by, you know, we have a creative community of musicians, players, thinkers. And that creative community is based in Southeast London, where I grew up, but also extends all over the world. We're traveling. We have the opportunity to travel to places we've never been before. And every time I look out at an audience, I'm helped very much by the fact that people have come together and that together we all make this thing happen, which is bigger than all of us. And that's extremely inspiring and humbling for an artist to have that opportunity, to be able to even talk to you on this particular show and to talk to these invisible listeners, whoever they are. This is something that we've been working towards for such a long time. So there is so much support that I've had over the years, both from people living and dead, you know, in terms of the inspiration that you get from artists that you listen to, artists you admire, from listening to the radio, from reading novels, whatever it is. You begin to feel part of a community that you can't access, especially as a kid, you know, before you've started this journey. You can feel this community that exists of the artists, of the novelists, and you feel a part of it. But suddenly, in this real life, suddenly now I am part of it, and it feels incredible, you know, to be able to be a musician, to be touring around, to be in America, you know, at this time. So I didn't really answer your question, but I said what I wanted to say, so that's important.
No, that's exactly. I wasn't looking to get into your personal life, but just about how you feel supported, and I'm not surprised to hear that you've known these musicians for a long time. It does seem like a family, and you are all locked in and on this journey together. And you take your audience on that journey, too. I mean, it's just magical to see you perform live. I want to thank you so much for coming in today. Kate Tempest's new album, Let Them Eat Chaos. And it's always a pleasure, as I said, to see you live. Thanks very much
for having us on.
You've got to tune to KEXP Seattle.
Discover new music at kexp.org.